Hi, I'm Mayor Baine Brooks. This is Let's Dish All the Positive Things in Allen, Texas. This is a video series where I interview different people in the Allen community that are bringing positivity to our city. Our guest this episode is Allen Police Chief Steve Dye. Tell us a little bit about your background.
Well, this May, Mayor, it'll be 40 years in public service. I know I started when I was five, so loved every minute of it. 35 years of those in policing. You know, we used to live in Allen, Mayor, and back then Bill Rushing was the chief, and I was assistant chief in Garland, and I was always on Bill about when are you going to retire, and Steve, I don't know. And then, of course, after I went to Grand Prairie as chief, Chief Rushing retired. So to have the opportunity to come back full circle, not only to serve as the police chief in Allen, but for my family and I to get to live in Allen again, where both of our girls graduated high school, it really is a blessing and a dream come true for me professionally. My first 20 years, I was a street cop. I worked patrol, narcotics. I was a motorcycle officer. I promoted up in the Garland Police Department to assistant chief of police. Later served as chief in Colleyville and Grand Prairie. About 9 years as chief in Grand Prairie, they asked me to go over to City Hall, serve as a deputy city manager, did that job, loved it, learned a lot. But you know, my passion, Mayor, is policing. And so when the opportunity to come to Allen came about, along with some other opportunities, my wife and I prayed about it. We turned down those other opportunities to come back here. So the welcome has been great. Everybody's just so friendly and welcoming and loving, and I inherited a great department. Really, really excited to see where we can take that in the future.
Well, you know, Allen's a little old bedroom community. We call it a boutique community. And, you know, you coming in and just jumping right in the middle of things. It's going to be fun for you and fun for us. But before we go there, tell us a little bit about your family.
Well, thank you for asking. That is the most important part of my life is my family. Faith and family are one and two every day, all day long. So I've been married to my lovely wife, knowing me for 33 years. I was a young rodeo cowboy back in the day, and a buddy that I rodeoed with had married her sister, introduced us October of 1989, got married in June of 90. You know, I could never do, Mayor, what I do serving the public without her love and support. So it's definitely a team effort. We've got two daughters. They're both grown. They're both public servants, have great careers, and a beautiful two-year-old granddaughter. Our oldest daughter's out of state. Our youngest daughter's here in Dallas. So, yeah, just been blessed with a beautiful family. And like you, Mayor, I'm a girl dad.
Yes. Yeah. It's pretty fun being a girl's dad because you know what? Once they hit 16, 17, they love daddies again.
Amen.
So we go that full circle.
Yes,
well, listen, do you, you know, since you've been out here policing, you've been several places, Garland, and do you have any mentors out there that you can speak of?
I do. So, you know, I start with my grandmother. My dad and my mom taught me an outstanding work ethic. You know, I always told our daughters growing up, don't complicate success. It's really only two things: work hard and get along with people. And if you'll do those two things at a high level, you can be successful. So certainly my family were mentors in the work ethic, and really I think through our faith, trying to show me how to treat others as I want to be treated, and greater good, trying to make the world a better place. And then, you know, Mitch Bates, my first chief in Garland, he double promoted me from lieutenant to assistant chief of police. He saw the potential in me to be a chief. Mayor, I never wanted to be a sergeant, much less a chief, but God had other plans. And so he saw that in me. And then Jennifer Fadden, my first city manager in Colleyville, and then Tom Hart, my city manager in Grand Prairie, really taught me a lot about leadership and organizational skills and some of those technical skills that they helped me learn. So, you know, on the professional side, those would be my mentors.
So we all heard, you know, you had some other opportunities before coming to Allen. Mm-hmm. And it's pretty special to hear some of those opportunities that you had, and you chose Allen. Why did you choose Allen?
Well, let me back up a little bit, Mayor. I'll first tell you, I'm nothing special. I'm just a man who loves serving the public, and I don't mind working hard. And I love my team. I love my community that I serve. So You know, I did. I had, over the years, I've had some really good opportunities. Been recruited quite a few times by some really big cities to be their chief of police. Most recently, I think we counted seven either offers or opportunities since I retired from city management. But as we prayed about it and reflected on it, it first came down to we loved living here so much. We wanted to be back and be part of the community. That's where it started with us. Mayor, you've been in Allen a long time. Our youngest daughter, her first job was for you back in the day. So, you know, it's just a wonderful community. It's very heartfelt, their appreciation for not just the public servants, but for everybody in the community. So that's where it started. And then, you know, I've known Chief Harvey for over 20 years. I knew Allen PD was a great department, but I knew there would be opportunities and challenges for me to try to make it better, right? Just like when I promoted my chief in Grand Prairie, when I went to City Hall, I told him, make us better. And that's the same thing that Brian would want. So I think the community spirit, I love the fact that we all go to one high school here. I think that's great, great school district. And so just, yeah, that community support, appreciation, and love that we feel here. And then being able to serve here, which is a job that I definitely wanted about 15 years ago, to get that opportunity again. I would have regretted it, Mayor, had I passed up on it this time. So, you know, huge thanks to Eric Elwanger for trusting in me and you as a mayor and council for believing in me to give me this opportunity. I'm very, very grateful.
Well, you know, you spoke earlier about inheriting a great team of officers. Mm-hmm. You know, we've seen them around here. We've seen them grow up. I've seen a lot of them grow up through the ranks. Mm-hmm. Some that's been here 20 plus years. And it's the culture. It's a culture that has been built that is really second to none. And you know, we get to know you, we see a big add value to that culture. I mean, speak on that culture and that add value at this point and going forward.
Yeah, absolutely. So, culture eats policy for breakfast every morning. The most important aspect of any organization are its people, and whether or not people come to your organization and stay is really predicated on the culture. You know, pay is like two or three. It's always culture. Yeah. So I want people that work at the PD, and not just our officers, but our civilian employees, to know that they're supported and appreciated. You know, I can't make you happy at work, but I'm darn sure going to give you every reason to be happy. I want people to have fun at work. I have fun at work. So we got a serious job. We're going to work hard, but I want us to have fun. I want us to appreciate each other. And then, Mayor, for me, culture starts with what is our why? What is our purpose? We're not enforcers. We're not call responders. It goes much deeper than that in policing. We should see ourselves as problem solvers focused on quality of life. We take that holistic approach to service, and when we do that and we engage with the community needs and priorities become our priorities, and we're better servants when we see ourselves as really how do we be good problem solvers and servants for that quality of life. So that way, no job is too menial for us. No job is too important for us. We're going to meet that need. And then finally, I think that culture is also predicated on the idea that whoever we encounter or engage with, everybody is treated with dignity and respect every interaction, every day. Even when we see people at their worst, which we do in policing, we're all still human beings, Mayor. Everybody is owed the treatment of dignity and respect.
Awesome. You know, once again, as we start this series of Let's Dish about all the positive things in Allen, I'm so glad we started with you, because you've come into this community. Everyone's accepting you. We're excited for you. You've got a great resume, great track record. We love that you're a family man and a person with faith. We love that. I think we know what we got when we got a chief die. So with that said, we're going to close this first segment. But before we do, I want us to know, and the folks in Allen that are watching this, give us something that we need to know about you that we don't know.
Well, before I get to that, Mayor, I also want to just tell you, thank you again for being the first guest on your show. I think this is awesome. So I guess probably, Mayor, you might be surprised, people might be surprised to know that not only did I grow up on a farm and a ranch, but I was a rodeo cowboy when I was younger. I rode bulls and bareback horses. So you know what my dad told me when I was young, Mayor? And I said, hey, Dad, Daddy, I want to be a rodeo cowboy. You know what he told me, Mayor? He said, son, if you're going to be stupid, you better be tough. So I've always remembered that, Mayor, but I love the sport of rodeo. So yeah, I was in my younger days, I was a rodeo cowboy. Played other sports, but was also pretty active in the rodeos.
Oh, wow, that's pretty neat. That's neat to hear. Yeah. Well, listen, once again, I want to thank you. I want to welcome you to Allen, Texas.
Thank you.
We are so excited to have you. And for those who are watching, let's dish about all the positive things in Allen.
Thank you, Mayor. I appreciate you.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.